I don't have a clue. All right, but it's got to be something to do with that government boy.
We'll talk to him, find out what he knows.
He fucking is. Where is she, Marston?
Who?
Who? My daughter, you fucking scum. Where's Bonnie?
I don't know. I haven't seen her since after the fire. Why?
Why? Because she hadn't been seen since yesterday afternoon. You know, I don't think I can cope. If I lose another child...
Now, Drew, nobody's lost anything yet. I'm sure she's fine.
Oh, Mr. Marshall! Mr. Marshall! Come out, wherever you are!
Who the hell's that?
Hey, buddy! That'd be your next fucking mare.
Even better! Good day, Mr. McFarlane!
Get down from that horse, boy, or I'll shoot.
I wouldn't recommend that, mister. Not if Drew McFarlane wants to see his bony back in one piece. Hey, Mr. McFarlane! This is a nice girl you got there.
Get out from there!
You know, part of me's got to thinking I should just marry her myself. Give her a baby and that.
What do you want?
That's better. I want Norman Deke. I want him set free. Then you'll get your daughter back, mister.
We don't do deals with outlaws, boy.
Yeah, you do. Let's not waste each other's time pretending otherwise. Old government themselves ain't much more than a bunch of crooks. This is the land of opportunity, mister. And I'm giving you the opportunity to get your daughter back before 15 friends of mine take out all their anger and their loneliness on her.
Where the hell is she?
Where is she, boy?
Bring Deke up to Tumbleweed in a couple hours. And don't get no funny ideas, or I will slit that horse throat myself. You boys have a pleasant afternoon. Yeah!
What do we do?
We do as he says. You and me, Marshal. Mr. McFarlane, I'll get you your daughter back. I owe her that.
Please do.
I'll teach you some respect for the law. Hurry up, boy. Let's go. Quick as you can, deputy. Make sure he's tied on good.
Stay with me, Marston.
I won't let anything happen to her, sir.
Come. Right. Let's go get Miss McFarlane back. See, this is what happens when the Federals interfere in our affairs. Are you happy now?
No, I ain't happy at all. And I already told you, I ain't with the government.
Now you say that, John, but the only thing I know for sure is who sent you.
They made me come here. They gave me no choice. That's your federal government, Mr. Johnson.
They come down here dressed as cocky as the King of Diamonds, talking a lot of flannel about helping us, about spreading peace and civilization to the West, but they brought nothing but trouble and taxes.
I agree with you. Wolves in sheep clothing, all of them. Rob you and make you pay to have someone investigate the crime on your behalf.
People around here have been fooled into feeling protected when they're worse off than they were before.
The fellas I know don't care about people. All they care about is lining their pockets. Why is this sorry son of a bitch so important to them?
Norman Deke, Williamson's right-hand man. In other words, a glorified errand
you
boy.
You wait, Marshal! I'll be back for you!
Bill's standards have slipped.
We already filled you with lead once, you ugly
Deke's
bastard!
The kind of man who's mean enough to be second in command, but too cowardly and stupid to ever be a leader.
Don't ever use that line near your deputies. You know, for his sake, they'd best not have laid a finger on Miss McFarlane. What is this place we're headed?
Tumbleweed? A lonely, godforsaken place. Some people say it's haunted. It was quite a town back in its day. Then they built the railroad to Armadillo and went clean past Tumbleweed. And that was that. Pretty soon, everybody had upped and left. Now it's just thieves, smugglers, and bandits. Scum like Deke here. Oh, popular spot for lynchings, too.
Let's try to avoid that if we can, Marshal.
I just hope you're not taking advantage of the McFarlane, Marston.
They saved my life. Gave me food and bed when they had no idea who I was. I owe them more than I can ever repay.
That's just they've been through a lot. Well, they're both vulnerable, different ways.
I wouldn't have been running in and out of a burning barn to save their horses otherwise.
I know you helped, just like you helped me. but you got your reasons for doing it.
It's no secret why I'm here, Marshal. I told you the very first time I walked into your office.
I trust you. It's just all this business with Blackwater and Williamson and the past. I don't know. Sometimes it's hard not to have doubts.
I understand. I never planned to be in the lawman business, neither.
How is this mess supposed to turn out? Sending an outlaw to do the work of a lawman. That's madness.
Ain't much difference between the two, as far as I can tell.
There have to be rules, Marston. Even you must understand that.
It's easy to make up rules, but they ain't much use if people don't understand why. Like my son. If I tell him not to do something, he'll do it anyways, just to spite me. If I punish him, he resents me for it. But if I show him why it's wrong, at least he has reason not to do it again.
That's nonsense. Without laws, we're nothing more than animals. You look at Deke here.
Go to hell!
Man has worked hard at civilization. If your boy steps out of line, you whack him. He does it again, whack him harder.
You're a good man, Marshal, and I respect what you're trying to do. From what I've seen since I've arrived here, the law ain't really working.
Criminals are like weeds, Marston. Quick as you stomp one out, another one sprouts up in its place. It's the nature of places. You know that as well as I do.
Stop spurring so hard, you son of a bitch! Slow down, will ya? Don't worry, my boys know how to treat a lady.
Across the bridge! Not far to go now!
Easy there.
John, you'll be exchanging the prisoner for Bonnie in the middle of town. Keep your eyes open. I sincerely doubt these scum plan to play fair.
Fair my ass.
You bet. Besides, Norm here is gonna be my shield, ain't you, Norm?
It'd be my pleasure.
Lead Deke into town. We'll be right behind you.
I'm sure it's been nice for the boys to have a whore to play with. I hear those rancher girls like it in the rear. Maybe she won't want to go home. She's been fucked so good.
Why don't you save some of that breath for breathing?
Get these ropes off me, boys!
Where's Bonnie? I thought we had a deal.
Take cover!
Are you supposed to be outlawed?
Are you okay?
I'm fine now, Mr. Marston. Thank you. Thank you. What the hell took you so long, you stupid man?
Well, you weren't exactly helping me.
If you think I'm gonna lower myself by making a joke about being all tied up, you got another thing coming. Come on.